Now, planets or grahas are the ingredients, the core ingredients that helps manifest an experience in your life. This is, try to be with me. If you have doubt, just raise your hands. I'll try to clarify this. This is where things become complicated. There are four ways in which a planet gives us result. As in, we have to study four aspects for us to cleverly understand how a planet will give you the results. I've given you this. First and foremost, each planet has a natural tendency. So it will give you an influence based on that natural tendency. Second one is on the zodiac that they occupy. So now we connect back to the environment that is there, how it will react with the environment. The third one is the houses or bhavas that they occupy or influence. And the fourth one is the houses or bhavas that they own. So these are the four ways of doing it. Now this we have studied everywhere. But what does it really mean when we say natural tendencies? What does it really mean that this particular planet is the owner of this house? Let's probably go one by one, right? First we'll go into the natural tendencies. Each planet, again, don't worry about the details of it. You can always download it online. But each planet has certain things that are very crucial for it, right? It has a sex, gender. It has an Ayurvedic constitution. It will tell you how it will give its karma. For example, if you look at the first one, Sun, it's a balanced nature. That basically means if you put energy for 10 minutes, it will give you 10 minutes equivalent of results. Whereas if you look at the Rajas, which is Mercury, it will give you an accelerated motion. So even if you put little, the outcome is more. So it's an accelerated style. Whereas if you look at Tamas, the next slide probably will have Tamas. Yeah, we have Saturn, which is Tamas. Even if you put 10 minutes of work, you probably might get only 1 minute of return in the entire thing. So this is how you have to understand the energies as well. Each planet also has a type of trait, which is either positive trait or a negative trait. For example, let's look at Rahu. I've said Rahu's positive trait is being an entrepreneur, exploiter, deceptive, incentivizes and briber. So this is a positive trait of Rahu. Now briber, is it a positive trait? People who have strong Rahu actually have very interesting jobs in the defense. They become spies. They are able to really talk about it, but they don't end up giving bribes. We have one very great fine gentleman here who actually have studied his horoscope. He has a great Rahu. He was actually a part of the Loka Yukta. So the gentleman and my mentor is right here. His name is Muni Krishna. And so you can actually look at his horoscope and you will start realizing this. He was the most feared man when he was a part of, when he held the position. And I have been fortunate enough to actually all throughout my life know him. He has carried me when I was probably 1 year, sir. Even less than that. So he's carried me from then and he continues to mentor me and help me throughout. So we have understood the tendencies each one will give. Let me make it a little more complicated. Next one will be the zodiac that they occupy. Now the planet, whichever zodiac he occupies, tells you whether this planet is auspicious or inauspicious. How is that? Let's look at this. Suppose a planet is in exaltation. What happens? He'll become 100% auspicious. If he is in Mula Trikona, he will become 75% auspicious. What does it mean? There's a 25% left where he'll become inauspicious in nature. If he is in own sign, it is 50-50. So he'll be part auspicious, part inauspicious. If he is in a friendly sign, it'll be 40-60. So he'll be 40% auspicious, 60% inauspicious. In an inimical sign, 25% inauspicious, 75% inauspicious. 25% auspicious, 75% inauspicious. And in a debilitated state, 0% auspicious, 100% inauspicious. If you all remember, Dr. T.S. Vasan mentioned about this, right? He spoke in Kannada. He said, Chatrusthandala Yadra Irbodhu Nicha Irkurdu, he said. Why? Because he becomes inauspicious in nature. He'll still give all the things that he has to give, but it'll always be inauspicious in nature. It'll not be auspicious in nature. Now this will give you the, this will show you any planet whether it is auspicious or inauspicious. Next would be the houses they occupy. Now what does the houses they occupy show you? If he is in quadrants, that is 1, 4, 7, 10, it will show, basically the houses they occupy show the strength of the planet. At any point of time, Rahu, is it going to be really powerful? Is it going to really affect me or not affect me? Same Rahu in the 7th will behave for differently in one for one person. Rahu in the 8th will behave differently in one person, provided other balas are same. Why is that? Primarily because if they are in quadrants, they will be exceptionally strong. If they are in Panapara, that is 2, 5, 8, 11, they will be medium strength. And if they are in Apoklimas, that is 3, 6, 9, 12, they will be weak. So Raja Yoga is there, 10th and 9th Lord conjunction. If it happens in the 6th house, unfortunately the Raja Yoga will not be very strong, primarily because 6th house weakens the planets there. There are certain special conditions which will overturn that also, but I think for today I am not going to get into the next level of thing. This is going to be a good hygiene factor for you to understand. Next we'll look at the houses they occupy. Now the houses they occupy will basically tell you the amplification of the trait that is there. So we talked about strength, we talked about auspicious nature, inauspicious nature, we talked about their natural tendencies. Next we'll look at the amplification of these things. Now how do we look at that? If planets are in 1, 5 and 12, if they own that house, 1, 5 or 12, invariably they end up doing a positive amplification of the entire life dimension. 3, 6, 11, if they own, they amplify it negatively. And if a planet owns both a quadrant and a trine, they will become exceptionally good, as in any good results, they will ensure that it happens. That's why it is called Yoga Karaka. Karaka, kr, comes from the word to do, to act. Yoga Karaka means they will ensure that it basically happens. So this gives you a quick overview of the planets as well, right? Let me again recap. Natural tendencies can be understood for a planet. Depending on the zodiac that they occupy, you can know whether it is inauspicious or auspicious. Depending on the houses they occupy, you can know the strength or weaknesses. And depending on the houses they own, you can make out whether they have amplification, what type of amplification they have, whether they have an amplification of a positive energy or they have an amplification of a negative energy. Let's take another one example for that. Let's take, say, for example, Jupiter. Now what is a natural keyword for Jupiter? Education, expansion, governance, these are all Jupiter, right? Now it's a masculine in nature, we know Kapha it is there. But what are the positive traits? Cheerful, optimistic, wise decisions and being calm. These are the positive traits of Jupiter. The same Jupiter can become inauspicious, and when it becomes inauspicious, the person becomes non-scientific in nature. So they tend towards superstition, blind beliefs in irutte avella jaasti hogutte. So they tend towards superstition, they start neglecting scientific approach at all. So mechanically they'll start following it. They don't pay attention to the details, so very generic, very superficial they try to act on it, and they don't really understand what the details are all about. And a person with Jupiter being inauspicious, the flip side is he will start henpecking and finding faults with everybody. You have everything will be right, but his eyes will only go to that area which is a wrong area. So 99% will be good, but he is not able to see that. He will only be looking at that one area, 1% where things are going bad. So this basically gives you how planets also do. So ZAP, this is the most important thing. I encourage you to read this as many times as possible, because if you know these three things, ZAP, zodiac, ascendant and houses and planets, by and large you are already very good in terms of analyzing a horoscope. If you have these three, this is like the trinity. If you have these three in your hands, you can comfortably analyze a horoscope. Next we'll go